Second half, and Serbia come right out of the gates and score to cut that deficit back to 5 points, and it was, guess who, Dabovic. And Spain so good at reacting and responding immediately. Get it for Nichols. Oh, beautiful pass and finish from Brooks.
You know, for so long, it was Milovanovic, and it's really, it's a little unusual to get used to calling her Brooks because she is so well known in the women's game, and you know her as Milovanovic.
That's right. Kyle missed. I'm not sure that was what Lucas Mondello wanted. Now Serbia have a chance to get even closer, to cut it to three or maybe even two. And under pressure, Petrovic throws the ball over the head of Dabovic.
We didn't see her back in after that.
Yeah, may have been resting her for the second half, but although...
It's Sylvia Dominguez.
I was about to say, the players that came in got the job done. And now Dabovic called for a foul on Laia Palau. Cruz dives. Jargai takes the shot and hits it from the line.
How many times have we seen that? You know, Serbia almost come up with a steal, and then it's almost like a dagger because Spain seems to always hit that shot.
Dakic, however, serves one up for Serbia. The team trading baskets. Up allowed to Endur, who turns left and then turns right. Oh, I'm sure that was the pass she meant to make, but it ended up with Petrovic, but then she missed with the left hand. Floats in. They just have shifted into a higher gear tonight.
They really have. It started yesterday, and it has continued on, if not even a little bit better, from yesterday's game. I mean, Ana Cruz has almost been perfect tonight.
Good rebound from Cervandakic. Over to Dabovic, short. Serbia just really in danger, and you wonder if Malkovic might get a timeout or will she get a sub. She's going to put Stankovic back in the game.
I mean, Stankovic did a great job when she came in, I thought, the first half.
She'll bring her in for Petrovic, and Nikolia is going to come in for Cervandakic. Spain, 29% from three-point range, 2 of 7. Serbia have yet to hit one. And double dribbles the call, so they get it right back. This Serbian team on. And Lyapalau reaches in and commits the personal. Spain's first in the third quarter. And just like in the first half, she takes a seat and Silvia Dominguez comes in. Murmurs like, why haven't you shot it? Because she knew what she was doing. So that was Palau's third foul, as you can see. And now Cruz comes up. Ivanovic had her hands up and was coming up with a steal. Good catch from Indoor and foul as she was guarded by Stankovic and Dabovic. Stankovic gets the foul. Number three.
But then after that, she started to get going. But she picked up her second foul and had to go to the bench for most of the first half.
That's right. Now, our guy reaches in, almost forces the turnover. She just has an engine that never stops, Marty Jargon. So, timeout on the floor. Spain have been able to increase their lead to 9 points since halftime. So the rebounding numbers pretty even, and Spain with six steals to Serbia's two.
Sí, Milovanovic cambio. De acuerdo, tenemos claro. Solo con la 10. Vale. Hey, jugamos. Acuérdate, Solner.
Ana Cruz, 13 points. Her best game of the tournament. And why do you think she is so effective? She just has that uncanny ability to be able to knife her way into the lane.
Yeah, she's incredibly quick, and she's also really crafty. But I think what gives her the ability to be able to get all the way to the basket for those nice finishes that we saw is her pull-up. Her pull-up jumper is incredibly effective. She's hit game winners with that kind of a shot. So you have to respect that at the same time, which means you have to get a little bit closer, and she's smart enough to be able to, and quick enough to be able to go by people if they're guarding her a little too close.
And then she's a pest on defense. Butolia has really come to the fore for Serbia tonight. She answers.
You know, really for Serbia, though, you kind of feel like they make great plays, but they don't get consecutive stops in a row. You know, they'll get one stop, get a score.
Oh, look at that. Double team comes. Somebody's open. Yeah. Well, the feed to Petrovic. Back to Stankovic. Maybe a little bit too far out. She wants to be closer to the basket, but she had that shot earlier, and she's like, here, Sonia, you take it. And that was the shot before where she got off in time. Jorgai, a break for Spain. That one seemed to be on its way down. And now the fans are upset because they called a jump ball.
It was a quick jump ball.
Ten offensive rebounds for Spain, eight for Serbia. Dominguez with the left hand. And Maj Forsberg says the star guy was out of bounds. This is where it's so difficult for teams that when a player gets a break, like Cruz, Mondello brings in a player like Uvena, although she probably doesn't have quite the offensive skills, at least from the jump shot variety.
You know, if you watch her in EuroLeague play the past couple of years with Boris, though.
She was able to hit him?
Yeah, she was very capable of knocking down three-pointers, pull-up jumpers.
Stankovic got back on the scoreboard. And again, Serbia refusing to go away.
But again, I keep saying they need to get multiple consecutive stops in a row, and they just have not been able to do that yet.
Uvena, let's see that jump shot. Oh, you were almost right. It went in and out.
Another offensive rebound for Spain.
Jorgai just goes hard to the basket. Look at that. Relentless comes to mind. That's the word. Totally into Stankovic. She turns again. It's fouled. Well, if anything, at least Serbia seemed to be finding an important weapon for the rest of this tournament and the future. Only 24 years of age, Dragana Stankovic. And remember, her previous high coming into this game was 7 points against Belarus.
I mean, you have Stankovic, you have Kevin Dakic. Serbian basketball is still, you know, there's a reason why they're playing in the semifinals.
Bitolia.
I mean, they have some exciting young players as well.
Well, she's got 9 points now, and Uvena comes down, and just like you said, Shona, she can shoot it from long.
That game last year for Spain, it was Cristina Uvena and Coral Casas who started against Canada, started knocking down the shots when Spain needed someone to score.
That's right. I had forgotten that. And you're right, it's Uvena with a tilde on the end. I was thinking more of her last game, which was 1 of 7 from the floor, and then the game against Latvia, she was just 1 of 5. She hadn't been shooting it well in this tournament, but here she is, Stankovic, and draws the foul again. And the crowd appealing for an unsportsmanlike. They could go look at it if they wanted, and I think they might. They're going to go take a look. Yep, here they come. So let's listen in as they go over. Here it is again.
I think it's with her, not the right hand. I think they're saying she kind of grabbed her with her left hand on the drive.
We can listen in.
Can you go back one more time?
Go back a little bit with the left hand.
I don't think it's enough. You go with the common.
Yeah.
Common foul.
Number four, right?
Well, the decision is not to award the unsportsmanlike. I'm not comfortable with that call, and I'll tell you, it just looked like, I don't know, maybe they're saying it wasn't intentional that her left arm was holding down the right arm, but it didn't look good to me. It looked a bit excessive.
But it's kind of funny because when the foul shot was called, Valerie Nichols looked at the ref like, what?
Yeah, but
which
that's
is very
the normal,
typical. They're very typical of the Spanish.
Spanish. Yeah. Yeah, they do not commit fouls. Well, at least Serbia catch a break there as Ruth tried to save it in bounds. And Lucas Mondello is now going to draw the ire of the crowd. And now they are going to reward. They're going to get the ball back to Spain. I think this is the right call because she throws it off the curve.
She was in bounds when she took that last jump and then was able to throw it off.
Certainly the crowd starting to get unsettled here by a couple of these calls. And it is a loud crowd. Now Petolia blocks Dominguez as she comes in from the left. Good play defensively there.
You hear the fans.
And leaving her feet with nowhere to go, Dominguez throws it into the hands of Cervandakić. And now Cruz reaches in and fouls Petolia.
Lucas Mondello. Look, you see him. He's trying to get his players to hustle in. I think he wants to talk to them. And this is a calm down timeout. It might not have a whole lot of structure about what to do, but it's, you know what, calm down, play your style. This is what we're going to do. He's getting a little chippy.
Estaba bien lo que has hecho. Ese saque de fondo no. Hay que abrirla fuera y jugar un pick and pop. Y una de las dos se queda sola, tía. Es pérdida y corre, no pérdida. Al menos perdemos tirando un tiro. Vale.
Cruz leading the scoring.
Vamos a jugar.
Although it's a balanced
attack.
Vamos a
jugar shoulder. ¿De acuerdo? Los bloqueos. El segundo bloqueo.
El polaco pasa de apilas y orma de 6 metri. Isto kao sprateli protiv ovih otpravi pozicijama. Losta mi usko.
And really the names that are missing there. You'd be looking for more points from Brooks. And maybe even Petrovic.
Yeah. I think Brooks has been quiet. Anna Dabovic, she only has 2 points so far in this quarter. But again, Dabovic playing less minutes than we're used to seeing. She does have that broken hand that we know about. And the woman that's on the line.
Ooh.
Has, you know, minus that miss, I think done a very good job coming in and being a replacement for Anna Dabovic. You'd like to see Petrovic and Brooks maybe take over here.
Ooh, two brutal misses, but Stankovic and now Petrovic. Again, they stay after it. Cervandakić again, another rebound. Petolia for three. And a foul called on Spain on the box out. On Nichols. Not sure what it was.
But you know what? It's not the time to complain. Momentum isn't really in Spain's favor right now, but saying that, I don't think Serbia has taken advantage of the momentum shift either.
That was Predrag Danilovic kind of leaning forward on his knees with his hands in his face, or his face in his hands, rather. And this is the worrying aspect as Cruz goes out, Žargaj comes in. This is, some people said this was Žargaj's Eurobasket to be the leader with Alba Torrens out.
I think I had her in my top five at the beginning of this, before the tournament started.
And is she there now?
I don't know. We've had some pretty big performances.
Ah. There is no end to the number of players
that are capable.
That are capable, yeah, of stroking big shots for Spain. Twelve turnovers now against Serbia. Žargaj pulls up. And I like how Stankovic is playing. She's really asserting herself on both ends of the floor. And turnover and a foul on Bukolia.
That's two turnovers by Bukolia. You know, I don't know if Coach Malkovich would want to maybe
bring Dabovic back.
Yeah. And they are going to go to a video review and see if this is an unsportsmanlike foul.
If they're rooting for Serbia, no, they are. No. You think it is? It is not going to be well received. They give it, seeing as how they didn't give it to Serbia
out
on the last
one. Wide out angle, please.
Make me go.
I think she's playing the ball. Do you?
I think she's playing the ball.
Yep. What is that, number?
Number 10.
Number 10? You good with
yes,
that?
Number 10.
Okay, common foul.
Yeah, so they said, you know, they believed that she was playing the ball. And like you said, I think the crowd would have gone crazy if they had called that an unsportsmanlike, but the one allowed in Nichols wasn't.
Yeah, that was probably a call made which aided stadium security. Tomorrow, Baldy is going to come into the game. Goes right around, but then didn't shoot it, tried to pass it, 3-on-1 break, and Jovanović, instead of going for the shot, tried to make sure there was contact. Yeah. I think she made a mistake. She should have gone for the basket. Look at this. Oh, no, she didn't. Sorry. It was Uvinja.
I think Jovanović brought down the ball and made it easy for Uvinja to, you know, just get a hand on it.
Bukolia, good rebound, Petrovic. Uvinja knocks it out of her hands, but it falls. Jovanović, and now Gil over Stankovic commits the foul, and they're over the limit, so free throws for Serbia, so that's not bad.
Serbia shooting 10 of 15. We haven't seen great free throw shooting in the last couple days here in Serbia.
Stankovic has hit 2 of 3 tonight. He's got 3 of 4.
And Serbia are 0 of 7 from 3.
Wow. And she makes both. They're still right there. Remember the same in the first semifinal, Great Britain, although they led for a lot of the first half. They fell behind, but they never, you know, France never really pulled away from it. The same in this game. See the free throw numbers in this quarter. And Abalde, ooh, almost hooked Petolia. Dominguez this time dumps it, and what a finish. I mean, that adds insult right there with Pena coming off the bench and hitting
first
the baseline
touch of
jumper.
The game, yep, you know, being
touch.
Able to.
Kevin Dockett pulls up. And she did not get it off in time, Ivanovic, so only 10 minutes remain. Serbia's hopes still alive for a spot in the final to face France, but it's those hopes are fading a little bit.